Compared to a lot of my videos that I've been putting out recently, this one's going to be a lot different. I really haven't made any sort of serious video like this in a long, long time. It involves losing ones that are close to you and everything, so it's a little hard for me to talk about this, especially when it's the same day that it's happened. But I just finished up with my Modern Warfare 2 Remastered series, and I figured I wanted to make a little bit of newer content and make something new instead of repeating the same methods that I have been for the past few months, and actually upload and create and genuinely edit and take the time into making a video, just like I kind of did a few weeks ago when I made that one montage for CSGO. I spent like 8 or so hours working on that. But anyways, that's not what the point of this video is. This is actually about something a little sad, so I'm sorry if I make anybody sad or anything like that, but I just kind of wanted to talk about it. It involves death, it involves growing up. It involves all these things that I've been feeling recently, especially with this happening. For those of you that don't know, 2019 was probably one of the worst years that I've ever had to experience. I mean, 2020 is a tough contender considering how awful the half of the year has been with just all the crazy stuff that's been happening. Just overall, though, 2019 was just not a good year for me. I had to go through some personal endeavors that I will at some point in the future, not anytime soon, but I will someday make a video on it and just explain everything. Not only that, but losing two of my best friends. I lost two of my lovely dogs, one of them that I grew up with, and then the other one that we got a few years prior, and we got him at a shelter, and we just gave him a final resting home, but he became a cute little guy, and I loved having him around. It was a shitty year. I'm not gonna lie, I feel like it did change me in a way. I know I have made some people upset, and I know that I've hurt people. I just know it just was not a good year overall, and I'm very glad that it's over, and I just can't wait for more years to go by so it can just get farther and farther away from my memory. With the passing of my two dogs, as well as the passing of our family dog who just passed away, rest in peace, Chase, we love you. It's just kind of got me in this sort of like a mental state of just like thinking about how time just goes by every second. I know it's really messed up to think about it in this way, and it's not that I think about it this way, but every once in a while I'll get that thought, like, you know how we think about life by days, months, years, but we don't think about it in seconds. Like, if you think about it and do the math, I don't even remember the number when I looked it up just out of like curiosity. I looked up how many seconds I probably have left to live, and it was weird. It was just like weird seeing that really high number that you know you're nowhere close to, but just feeling it when it's closer instead of it being even days, when you go by seconds, it has like this really, really weird atmosphere. It just felt strange. Like, what if you do only have 23 billion seconds left on this earth, or whatever the number is? That might be way overboard than what the number was, but like I said, I don't really want to look it up again. And I don't want that to come out sounding depressing or sound like I'm, you know, depressed or anything. I'm very fortunate enough to not know what that's like. I do know that I have like social anxiety, or I get anxiety just especially with particular things that I won't really get into detail about, but I don't want to worry anybody or make people think that like I'm in a weird place right now. I am kind of, but not in like any sort of dangerous way. So I'm sorry if that's like the message that's coming across here, or that I'm making this video suddenly and like out of the urge of being upset because of our dog passing away. But no, it's none of that. I promise you guys. I just, with everything that's been going on inside of my head, I just kind of wanted to use it as a way to make a commentary video and be able to talk to you guys and be up close with you guys, just like I used to be and just like I plan to do. Just like when I made that video talking about the changes that were going to be made to this channel, like playthroughs and commentary videos and stuff like that. So I'm trying to bring all that back. Maybe I will bring vlogs back at some point, who knows. But speaking of vlogs, one thing I did want to mention is the reasoning for this title of this video. It's going to be not exactly a follow-up, but a sequel to the original Memoriam video. If I think about it or I remember to link it, I'll link it in the description in case anybody wants to watch it. I'm not going to play any of the footage on my video because it's kind of awkward because I cry in the video. I was younger. I was just out of high school and one of my other dogs passed away and I was really upset and it was hard to talk about. I've just never really been good with death. I'm pretty sure it's not anybody's thing, but I feel like in a way I deal with it the hardest, especially when I'm so close to somebody, and it's scary. But following up with that whole 2019 wasn't a good year and losing two of my animals, two of my dogs, the original was when in 2016 when I lost my first dog, which his name was Bear. He was a sweetheart. He kind of, in a way, this isn't intended to sound like I'm making fun of him, but in a way he kind of had PTSD. At least that's what we thought, because we got him when he was older. And like in certain places when you would go to touch him, he would kind of like turn really fast and try and like bite you, I think out of fear. It wasn't like he was a mean dog. He was actually a real sweetheart. We just think maybe he was abused, or maybe his older owner did things to him when he like did something wrong. So maybe that's why he acted like that whenever you would touch him. And like, I think towards like the inside of his legs, like say to go pick him up, because he was a medium sized dog. He wasn't big like Chase, our lab that just passed. He was like kind of in between. I honestly can't remember what his breed was. It was a mixture between like a border collie and something else, if I remember correctly. But losing him was really hard. But I knew deep down that the one that was going to be hardest for me was going to be my Pomeranian Terrier mix, Dewey. He originally wasn't really my dog. He was more a dog for my grandparents, in which they ended up giving back to us because they couldn't take care of him. So we ended up taking him under our wing. And for a big portion of his life, he was an outside dog. And I was younger. I was a lot more naive. I didn't really think about the animals in that sort of way. I didn't think about their time or thinking about going to pet them or hang out with them more. And that really bit me in the ass once I started to realize that time was short. I'm not saying this is not an exaggeration, but I'm pretty sure it was almost 2 weeks before Dewey's passing. I had a dream about taking him to the vet. The dream was really messed up. It was really weird because it wasn't like anything realistic, and it was really like, and it was really traumatizing because it was, like I said, it wasn't something that would normally happen in this sort of situation. But if I remember correctly, Dewey had to go to the vet because he lost like all four of his legs. And so they ended up putting him to sleep, obviously, because there's no way an animal or a dog especially could maneuver and do anything without his legs. And I remember waking up and my eyes were watering, so I'm assuming I was crying in my sleep. But I immediately grabbed him and I held him and I sat there and I laid with him for probably an hour or so, just petting him and loving on him. That was when it clicked in my head that time is short, or to, you know, make sure you love on your animals a lot more. So I took those 2 weeks, and pretty much any time that I wasn't doing anything, I wasn't working or I wasn't playing video games, I would put Dewey on my lap, or I would go lay with him in my bed and I would hold him. I felt guilty in a way because it took me almost his entire life to finally appreciate him or to fully understand how dogs, or what dogs are, and that they're special. I've always thought dogs and other animals were special, and I've always loved them, don't get me wrong, but taking care of them in the regard of like always loving on them and assuring them and stuff, just like humans, is very important. And I'm very glad for that dream and for that experience, because I know from that point forward, I have been a lot more loving with all the animals. And by that, I mean going to them, saying hi, petting them and stuff like that, and giving them attention like they deserve. But like I said, about 2 weeks later, he ended up having seizures. He started having mini seizures and he started shaking a lot. And we took him to the vet, and I had in the back of my mind like that doubt that this is going to go well. I had a very good feeling that this was the last time I was going to get to see him or hold him. And I'm sitting there terrified. I don't want this to end. I don't want to lose him. We go to the vet, talk to him or whatever. They ask if we want to do blood tests and all that. And at this point, he's an older boy. I can't remember his age, if I'm being honest. He was probably like 13, 14. But it just felt best, and we didn't want him to suffer anymore, so we ended up putting him to sleep. That last moment that I had with him, holding him in my arms as he's sitting there shaking and they put him to sleep, that was hard. And I didn't think I was going to cry in this video, but I am a little bit right now, if I'm being honest. But I wanted to make a video in memoriam to my animals and our animals that have been passing, and to follow it up with something that I'll talk about later. Because last year I wasn't able to make a video at the time when he passed because I didn't have a computer still. So it's nice being able to, you know, pay my respects to all my animals and to talk to you guys about them and everything. But yeah, so that was hard. That happened in June of 2019, and about 3 months later, I lost my other dog, Teddy. He was a Chihuahua that we found, that we took care of from the shelter. We had him for a few years. He originally was going to be my dad's dog for his final years, but then he ended up just living down here with me, with Dewey, and they became little buddies and just hung out together and did stuff. But with Teddy, it was a lot different. I, like I said, when Dewey passed, at that point, I was a lot more appreciative of my animals, so I definitely did take the time to love on Teddy a lot as well. And because he was my last dog, I wanted to make sure that he got all the love that he deserved. So this one was a lot more sudden too. It was unexpected. It was very sad waking up the next morning, especially because you're pretty sure that he suffered. But I remember one night I was like up late playing my games. I think I got home from work. This was when I was working like a 3 to 1:30 shift or something like that at my job. But I came home and he kind of was making a lot of sounds with his stomach, and he was whining a little bit, which was something that he didn't usually do. So I kind of felt like something was wrong, but I was kind of oblivious and I didn't really think much of it. So again, I do feel like I have guilt in a way because of this, but pretty much I ended up laying with him for probably an hour. I held him and I just pet him and I rubbed his tummy, and he ended up going outside because that's what he would usually do. He'd try and go back and forth from going inside and outside, but I figured he had an upset stomach, so I left the window or the little doggy door open. Usually I would close it at night, and I ended up waking up the next morning and I found him in the corner of my yard, and he passed away. That was hard, having to walk up with him to my girlfriend in tears, showing her what, I had to wake up and see. That was pretty mind-numbing as well. So we ended up burying him that morning. So that's what happened to both of my dogs in the same year, 3 months apart. So that was one of the reasons why I really did not like 2019. With all that happening, I took care of Chase a lot more. I would always go and say hi to him. I would pet him. In the end, though, I am happy, though, that all of my animals or all of the animals are in a better place. Chase, he was a black lab. He was a good boy. He was a little bit of like a crazy knucklehead when we first got him, and for quite a long time, actually. He wasn't really trained right, and that was our fault. But he was an outside dog. We had him watch the property and bark at strangers and stuff just to keep us alerted when things would happen. He pretty much just died of old age. He was getting older. We just figured it was best. But he was a very, very good boy as well. It's just very, I was very sad last night. I went over to him and I apologized for not giving him all the time that he deserved growing up, that I loved him, and I hope that he's going to be happier up there and he's going to be able to run forever and have all sorts of fun with all of our other animals. I told him to say hi to Dewey and Teddy for me. And it's hard. It just sucks how it never gets easier. You'd think that you would just be more adjusted to it and understand that it happens, but it's never easier. You never want your animals to pass. And it makes it hard for me to want to get another animal because I don't want to, in 14, 15 years, to have to go through that same pain again. I don't know. Currently, I don't have any dogs. I'd like to get some, but I'm a little bit hesitant on it, and but with that all in mind, the whole growing up concept, that's what I kind of wanted to end this video on, just kind of talking about the whole idea and the concept of growing up. And it's weird knowing that, I grew up with those dogs, not Teddy or Bear, but I grew up with Dewey and Chase. Thinking about how, say, if we were to get another lab, to watch outside, the fact that they were in a different era just like we were, or the fact that their view on things were probably different than what animals view now, if that makes sense. I understand that they're just dogs, but the idea that, when I was little, like video games, when the PlayStation 2 was like the biggest console and the best console out there, and now we've got the Xbox Series X coming out and the PlayStation 5, and we have these beast-ass PCs that we can build. You know what I mean? So I don't know. I've just been in kind of that mindset recently, just thinking about that and the idea that animals now are going to have a different view and a different setting on things, and that they're going to go through different parts of life just like we are. It's strange to me. We have two young orange cats right now. They're both brothers. I think they're probably like 1, maybe 2 years old. And just like imagining how, when I'm 35 or something like that, that'll probably be when they're older, and that's when their time is going to be up, and then it's just going to be another cycle. I don't know. That was kind of a weird ramble and a weird thing to say, I guess, but that's kind of how I view things. Yeah, I hope you guys did enjoy the video, though. I just wanted to pay respects to all of our animals that have been passing recently, or Chase, who passed today, and Dewey and Teddy and everybody. But it just felt like it was right, and it felt like it was something that I wanted to make. I knew that I was going to want to wake up today and I was going to want to talk about it. A lesson that I want from this video from you guys is I definitely recommend you give more time to your animals. Love on them more. Appreciate them more, because you don't know when it's going to be over. Yeah. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys have a great day. More content to come. And take it easy, everybody.